Today, I am going to speak about what the Holy Spirit can do in our life. And the topic is the importance of the Holy Spirit in Christian life. You know, there are some people are thinking that by the work of the Holy Spirit, we have come to Christ and we have had an encounter with Jesus Christ, and we come to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. And some of the people are thinking that, you know, that is over and that is enough for a believer, that when we come to Christ and when we accept Jesus as a personal Savior, it was through the work of the Holy Spirit. And that's true that it was through the work of the Holy Spirit that we came to know about Jesus Christ. You know, and some other people think that, you know, that is enough, and we don't want to know more about the Holy Spirit, or we don't want to experience the presence of the Holy Spirit after that. No, but we have to understand one thing. When we study about the Holy Spirit and the importance of the Holy Spirit in a Christian life, think about, you know, how this Holy Spirit can move in us and how the Holy Spirit can guide a person or a believer. So that is what we are going to think about this morning in this Sunday service. We have to think about the Holy Spirit can do more things in our lives. That means there are many works of the Holy Spirit in the Bible. You know, when we study about the Holy Spirit and different aspects of the Holy Spirit, we understand, you know, there are many things to share about the Holy Spirit, but I'm not going to focus on all those things, because we know that the personality of the Holy Spirit is there and the work of the Holy Spirit is there, both in the Old Testament and the New Testament. And there are gifts of the Holy Spirit, and fruit of the Spirit is there, and speaking in tongue, that also is there. And various terms are using for the Holy Spirit. That means that the infilling of the Holy Spirit, indwelling of the Holy Spirit, and baptism of the Holy Spirit, anointed by the Holy Spirit, and power of the Holy Spirit. And all those things are written in Bible in different ways. But today, I'm not going to focus on all those points, because all those points are there. At the same time, I know that we people, all of us, are from different church background or different religious background or something. And if I go to those things and focus on those things, that will make a confusion among the people of God. So I would like to, I would like to stand with the main point. What is the importance of the Holy Spirit in a Christian's life? Now think about, you know, when we think about the Holy Spirit, we have many understanding about the Holy Spirit. You know, everyone has their own understanding about the Holy Spirit. Everyone has their own knowledge about the Holy Spirit. And some people are thinking that, okay, this is the way that we have to practice the Holy Spirit. And the other people are thinking that this is the way, this is the only way that we have to think about and we have to practice the Holy Spirit. But let all those things be there. No, when we read the Bible, we understand there are many things that the Holy Spirit can do in our personal life. These days I can see that, you know, in many churches, they are using different kinds of strategies for the growth of the church. No, you can see that in different churches in even in United States also. Now, there are many churches, they are using many strategies for the growth of the church. But I personally believe that the strategies will not work out in a church, in a Christian church, in a spiritual church. But I understand one thing, that when the church and when the pastor and when the responsible people and when the people of God, the believers of the church, are submitting themselves under the Holy Spirit and the presence of the Holy Spirit and the power of the Holy Spirit, that will work out, and that will cause to the people, to the churches, to grow. rapidly. You know, even if you're not seeing a rapid growth of the church, even then no problem. Trust in the Lord. And we have to be trusting in the Lord, and also we have to be submitted in the hands of God, and we have to experience the presence of the Holy Spirit in our personal life, in our church, in our society, wherever we are going. So that is the important thing that I would like to share with you this morning. You know, if we are not experiencing the presence of the Holy Spirit in our life, nothing is going to happen. Nothing is going to happen. You know, because we know that the Holy Spirit is one of the main and important part of the Trinity. Main and important part of the Trinity. Father God, Son Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Okay, so these three persons are there in the Trinity. But think about what is the role of the Holy Spirit in a believer's life. We know what is the role of the Father God in a believer's life. We know what is the role of the Son Jesus Christ in a believer's life. But many a times we are just forgetting one thing, that there is a role for Holy Spirit in a Christian life. Have you ever think about that? You know, we know many things about Holy Spirit, and we know many things about Father God. We know many things about Jesus Christ, but we are not thinking about the Holy Spirit, and we are not thinking that what the Holy Spirit can, do in my life, my personal life, and what Holy Spirit can, teach me. We are not thinking about that, but we are going to that point, and we are saying that, when we are trusting in the Lord, and when we are, submitting ourselves for the work of the Holy Spirit, and when we are submitting ourselves for the presence of the Holy Spirit, every moment of our life, our life will be transformed. Our life will be transformed. The situation of a church will be transformed. Personally, I believe in the Lord that when we are submitted in the presence of the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit can do many more things in our life. Amen. You know, first of all, you can see that, you know, as a person of the Trinity, we accept the Holy Spirit. As a person, the third person of the Trinity, we accept the Holy Spirit. And you know, when you read Genesis chapter 1 verse 2, can you read Genesis chapter 1 verse 2? Anybody can read that? Yeah. Darkness was over the surface of the deep. And the Spirit of God was moving over the face of the waters. That means the Spirit of God, it was in the Old Testament, and the same Holy Spirit is there in the New Testament also. You know, this is the first mention about the Holy Spirit in Bible. Okay, this, Genesis chapter 1 verse 2 is the first mention that you can see in Bible in the Old Testament about the Spirit of God. So about the Spirit of God, the Bible says that the Spirit of God was moving over the face of the waters. Okay, it is not written God was moving over the face of the waters, but it is written the Spirit of God was moving over the face of the waters, which means, you know, God can work in different places. At the same time, God is using the Spirit of God to work in different places. You know, that doesn't mean that God cannot work. That doesn't mean that Jesus cannot work. But God is assigning, and God is giving that responsibility to the Holy Spirit and saying that you have to do something in that particular matter. So this morning, let me speak to you. Let me tell you one thing, that the people, those who are sitting here, God, if God is allowing the Holy Spirit, and if God is telling and assigning the Holy Spirit to work among us, and if the Holy Spirit is coming upon us, and the Holy Spirit can do something towards us. Every person, God is going to send the power of the Holy Spirit, and God is going to send and assign the Holy Spirit to do something in that person's life, in your life and in my life. When we are submitted for that, and God says that, okay, I'm sending the Holy Spirit and asking the Holy Spirit to work or move, you know, the Holy Spirit can do, move over the waters, then the Holy Spirit can also move on every one of our lives. Amen. That's what we understand from there. And you know, we have to think about what are the ministries of the Holy Spirit. We are looking into that point. Now, what are the ministries of the Holy Spirit? The second slide. The ministries of the Holy Spirit. You know, when, you know, we know that, for everything and everyone, there is a ministry. You know, a pastor has a ministry. The elders has their own ministry. And the responsible people, the deacons, have their own ministry. Every believer, they have their own ministry to do in the church and outside the church. You know, we have our own ministries to do. Now, every person, even, you know, in Trinity also, God the Father has his own ministry, his own work to do. And Jesus the Son has his own ministry. And the Holy Spirit also has his own ministry. Okay, we call the Holy Spirit he. Why? It's a person. No, Bible clearly written that Holy Spirit is a person. Father God is a person. Jesus is a person. And Holy Spirit is a person. So we are calling that the Holy Spirit can do many things. The Holy Spirit has many ministries. You know, think about, you know, if something is happening in our life and you have to remember that it is the work of the Holy Spirit, because now the Holy Spirit is given. You know, when Jesus was ascending to heaven, you know, Jesus, I will send the Comforter to you. I will send the Comforter to you, and I will send the Holy Spirit upon you people, and you will receive the power, and you will do the ministry, and you will testify me, witness me in all over the world, Judea, Jerusalem, and Samaria, and all over the world. You will go and preach the gospel, and you will witness me. So that means when the Holy Spirit is coming upon a person, the person will be empowered. That is the ministry of the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit is leading a person, that person will be always doing the ministry of the Lord, or doing something for the glory of the Lord, or doing or preaching the gospel, sharing the gospel. So for that, we needed the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Amen. Spreading the gospel, preaching the gospel, sharing the gospel. We need the insight of the Holy Spirit. We need the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. And we need the power of the Holy Spirit. That's what we read in Acts chapter 1. Now, Jesus said that, okay, I will send the Holy Spirit upon you, and you will go. And you will go. You know, the evangelism, you know, we have been listening from dear Jostan maybe a few weeks ago about the evangelism. You know, for evangelism, what is the first thing that we have to have? The power of the Holy Spirit. We need the power of the Holy Spirit. Without the power of the Holy Spirit, when we share the gospel, that will not work out. But if you have the power of the Holy Spirit, because that's what we understand when Jesus was saying to his disciples. Amen. So that's the reason I said, you know, when we do something, if you are going with the power of the Holy Spirit, and that will work out. If you are not going without the power of the Holy Spirit, nothing will work out there. I mean, that's what we understand. There are many ministries for the Holy Spirit. The first ministry of the Holy Spirit is the ministry of regeneration. Okay, what is the meaning of regeneration? Regeneration means The born again experience. Okay, from when you read John chapter 3, especially John chapter 3 verse 5. No, there, the, yeah, you can read, yeah. Yes, what is that? No one can enter the kingdom of God unless they are born of the water and the Spirit. Listen, we cannot enter into the kingdom of God unless we are born of the water and the Spirit. You know, the theologian says that the water is simplifying about the Word of God, and the Spirit is the Holy Spirit. Listen, so when a person is coming to Christ, and when a person is accepting Jesus Christ, that is the work of the Holy Spirit. Okay, that person is born again, that person is regenerated only because of the Word of God and also the Holy Spirit. Okay, that's the reason to Nicodemus, Jesus is saying, you know, I know that you are a great man. I know that you know everything from the Bible, and you know the Old Testament and the scripture, everything. But the thing is, even though you are a teacher, you have to be born again if you want to go to the kingdom of heaven. This is the main thing that we understand. When the Holy Spirit is working in a person, that person will be regenerated. Okay, the birth of that person, the rebirth of that person is happening when the Holy Spirit is working in a person. Okay, remember, you know, I was just thinking about a story which I heard from our pastor. You know, he was saying that, okay, there was a home and there was a family. That family had 10 chicks, okay, the baby chicken. So they were growing those chicks, and one day what happened, you know, there were 10 baby chicks, and as it was growing in that house, you know, this what is that, you know, one among the chick, I think somebody have already shared that one, you know, one among that chick was thinking, okay, why I'm just what is that, playing with all these chicks and everything. And once the eagle came from above, and the eagle was looking at this chick and saying that, okay, hey baby, why you are playing here, why you are playing with these chicks and everyone. Then the chick said, okay, I'm a chick, and that's why I'm just playing here. And the eagle was asking, why you are playing here, and what you are searching here. And he was saying, I was searching some food. Okay, I need some food, and the other, my brothers and sisters are here. You know, my brothers and sisters, the baby chicks are here, and I'm just playing with them, and I'm just searching for the food for me. Then the eagle said, don't you know that, who are you? Then that chick said, no, I'm a chick only. Then the eagle said, no, you are not a chick. You tried to fly. You just tried to fly. And that chick was trying to fly, but it could fly something above. You know, then the eagle said, no, you are not a chick. You are not a chick. You are an eaglet. You are an eaglet, and you can fly little more high. You can fly little more high. Then this baby said, no, I cannot fly because I am a chick. I cannot fly. Then the eagle said, no, you try flying, you can do that because you are born as a baby eaglet. ഒരു കഴുകന്റെ കുഞ്ഞായിട്ട് ജനിച്ച ഒരാൾക്ക് ഒരിക്കലും ഒരു കോഴിക്കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളുടെ കൂടെ നടക്കാൻ പറ്റത്തില്ല. സ്തോത്രം, ഹല്ലേലൂയ്യ. So what happens there, that eaglet tried to fly and it could fly up to the eagle. So this will happen only because of the birth of a person. You know, it is sure that we have the natural birth, right? We have the natural birth, and we are born into this world as we have the physical body, and we have the natural birth. But when we are regenerated, and when we are reborn, and when we are born again, then our status is changed. You know, the status of the natural birth is changed to the spiritual birth. We are born again, and now we are the children of God by the Spirit. By the Holy Spirit, when we are born again, now we can say that I had the natural birth, but I am a special baby. I am a special boy. I am a special girl because I am born again. So hallelujah. So that's what we understand from the life and the birth of Jesus Christ even. You know, when you read Matthew chapter 1 verse 18 says that Jesus was born by the Holy Spirit. Listen, Jesus was born by the Holy Spirit. And that is very clear that in Matthew chapter 1 verse 18. We know that very well. At the same time, after the birth of Jesus Christ, you know, Jesus was born by the Holy Spirit. Okay, Jesus was born by the Holy Spirit. We are born as a human, but Jesus was I mean, taking the form of a human, and it was, the birth was by the Holy Spirit. We had our natural birth, but at the same time, the second birth that we are having is the rebirth, or what is that, born again experience or regeneration. Okay, so Jesus did not had to born again, right? Jesus never, I mean, had an experience of born again experience, right? Did he had? No. Jesus never need to, I mean, born again, because he was born by the Spirit. Okay, we need to born again because we had a natural birth, but now to become the children of God, to become the spiritual child of God, we have to born again. Okay, and when Jesus was born, again in Luke chapter 1, verse 80, Luke chapter 1, verse 80, read that verse. Okay, when the child was born, that is, Jesus was born, he grew and he became strong in spirit. Listen, okay, Jesus was born and he was growing in the wisdom of God and man, and also he was becoming strong in spirit. Listen, what was the need of becoming, for Jesus to become strong in spirit? Okay, becoming strong in spirit. You know, if Jesus was supposed to, I mean, become strong in spirit, how much more we need to be strong in spirit? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We need to be strong more and more. If Jesus had to have that strength in spirit, Jesus was God, 100% a God, and Jesus was 100% man. Even Jesus had to grow, and Jesus had to grow with the wisdom of man and God, and Jesus had to have the strength of the Holy Spirit, then how much more we will have to have that, spirit and the need of the spiritual, activities. Hallelujah. Praise God. You know, when we study about the life of Jesus Christ, in the birth of Jesus Christ, there was the importance of the Holy Spirit, right? At the birth of Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit was important. In his infant stage, the Holy Spirit was with him, and importance of the Holy Spirit. And in his teenage, there was Holy Spirit to speak something. And in his youth, the Holy Spirit was working in Jesus Christ. So I was just thinking, you know, if the Holy Spirit was important in the life of Jesus, in all through the life, that means in his birth and infancy and teenage and youth and youngster, and as all in that steps, in all those stages, if the importance of the Holy Spirit is visible, then how much more as we are growing in this wretched world, we need the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We need the power. We need the presence of the Holy Spirit every moment of our life. It is not easy to live in this wretched world. I mean, day to day, the world is becoming wretched, 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 and worse and worse and worse. You know, the pandemic situation is worse and worse and worse now. The new corona variant, Omicron, is spreading all over the world. Especially I think in the news it came that almost 16 or 17 states in United States also it is affected, the Omicron. You know, the things are getting worse and worse and worse. You know, the people, of this world, even in the midst of this, the people are living a wretched world. Okay, and living a wretched life. And the people are going after the pleasures of this world. But how many of you are thinking this morning, well, Lord, I need the presence of the Holy Spirit in my life, oh God. And I need the power of the Holy Spirit, oh God, in my life, oh God. Otherwise, I cannot live in this wretched world. Think about our children. Think about our children. Hallelujah. Our children, are the born again children, and they have the experience of the rebirth or regeneration. But at the same time, as they are living in this wretched world, pray for our children, so that they also will be, always trusting in the Lord, and they also will be trusting the presence of the Holy Spirit and guidance of the Holy Spirit in their life. Hallelujah. Praise God. We are going to the next portion. Maybe, you know, let me give you some of the points which shows how much important was the Holy Spirit in Jesus' life. And I will read it from here, and you can see that in the slide. Amen. So, you know, the Holy Spirit was important in the life of the importance of the Holy Spirit in the life of Jesus Christ. First of all, Jesus was born by the Holy Spirit, according to Matthew chapter 1 verse 18. Jesus was born by the Holy Spirit. And I'm trying to tell you that, you know, how much more we need the power of the Holy Spirit. We need the presence of the Holy Spirit if Jesus had the importance of the Holy Spirit in his life. Jesus was led by the Spirit. Jesus was born by the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit descended on him at his baptism in Luke chapter 3 verse 22. Jesus was led by the Spirit into wilderness to be tempted. Luke chapter 4 verse 1. Listen, now Jesus was led to the wilderness by the Spirit to be tested by Satan. So this is very interesting to know that, you know, sometimes we also will be led by the Holy Spirit into some particular places where we will have the temptation. If Jesus had the temptation in that way, we also will have the temptation in that way. But we have the experience of the born again. We have the regenerated experience, and we can overcome all the temptations of Satan. That is the difference between the natural birth and the spiritual birth of a person. Listen, so Jesus, led by the Spirit into wilderness to be tempted, Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Holy Spirit. Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Holy Spirit. Luke chapter 4 verse 14. Jesus, the Spirit of the Lord was upon him in Luke chapter 4 verse 18. The Spirit of the Lord was upon him in Luke chapter 4 verse 18. And Jesus rejoiced greatly in the Holy Spirit. Jesus rejoiced greatly in the Holy Spirit. Luke chapter 10 verse 21. Jesus performed his ministry in the power of the Holy Spirit. Jesus performed his ministry in the power of the Holy Spirit. Acts chapter 2 verse 22. Jesus was anointed with the Holy Spirit. Jesus was anointed with the Holy Spirit. Acts chapter 10 verse 38. And Jesus was died by the eternal Holy Spirit. Hebrews chapter 9 verse 14. Jesus was died by the eternal Holy Spirit. We are not taking time to read all those portions because we know that, and you can maybe check with those verses at home. Okay, so Jesus was died by the eternal Holy Spirit, Hebrews chapter 9 verse 14, and Jesus was resurrected in the Spirit. Jesus was resurrected in the Spirit, 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 18. Hallelujah. So, you know, when you go through these verses, you will understand, you know, all through the life, Jesus was experiencing the presence of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, so the first ministry of the Holy Spirit, I told you, that was the ministry of regeneration. The ministry of regeneration. We will go to the second ministry of the Holy Spirit. The second ministry of the Holy Spirit. That is the teaching and illuminating ministry. The teaching and illuminating ministry. Illuminating in Malayalam? Prakashipikya? Illumination? Prakashipikya. Okay. The teaching and the illuminating ministry. Okay. Let us read John chapter 14 verse 26. John chapter 14 verse 26. Amen. So Jesus said, I will ask to my Father, and Father will send the Holy Spirit upon you into this world, and that Holy Spirit will teach you all things and remind you all that I have told you. Listen, you know, when the Holy Spirit is coming upon a person, the Holy Spirit can teach a person. Teaching, you know, that's a ministry, actually, the teaching ministry. or illuminating ministry. You know, some people are, I mean, taught by the Holy Spirit. You know, there are many people, those who have not gone to the Bible college or something for studying something, or but there are many people sitting in the presence of God, and the Holy Spirit will teach those people, and Holy Spirit will, I mean, give some, I mean, illumination on that, I mean, person, and that person used to, I mean, study something, I mean, out of the Holy Spirit, and through the Holy Spirit they are getting many, I mean, depth of the word of God. You know, we have to understand many things, that when the Holy Spirit is coming upon a person, that person also always will be taught by the Holy Spirit. Teaching ministry is there. Illumination ministry is there. That means, you know, in Mark chapter 13 verse 11, Jesus was promising to the disciples. Okay, in Mark chapter 13 verse 11, Jesus promised, when you are arrested or when you are handed over to the authorities, don't worry, Holy Spirit will give you what to say. You know, the disciples were, Jesus Christ was telling them that, okay, disciples, now you are okay, and I'm there, and I will be going from here, I'll be crucified, and I'll be ascended to heaven. Then after that, at the end time will come, and you will have the persecution. You will have the persecution. So the disciples were very much worried about all those things, and they were asking, oh Jesus, where are you going? I mean, can you show the way where you are going? Can you show the place where you are going? We can also come there. Then Jesus said, no problem. I am sending the Holy Spirit to you, and the Holy Spirit will teach you what to do. The Holy Spirit will, I mean, give you the illumination, and the Holy Spirit will guide you, and the Holy Spirit will direct you, and also the Holy Spirit will give you the words that you have to speak to the authorities when you were arrested and when you were handed over to the authorities. Hallelujah. Amen. Think about, you know, those people were helpless, and those people were just thinking, okay, what can we do if we are arrested and if we are handed over to the authorities' hands, and what can we do? They were thinking and thinking and thinking. Then Jesus said, no worries. Hallelujah. No worries. You will know, and the Holy Spirit will give the word to your mouth what to say to those authorities at that time. ആ സമയത്ത് നിങ്ങളുടെ വായിൽ പറയേണ്ടത് എന്താണെന്ന് ദൈവം നിങ്ങളുടെ വായിൽ പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാവിനാൽ നൽകപ്പെടും. You know, most of the time, you know, we people are worried about many things. And we, you know, we speak to each other and okay, Pastor, I don't know what to do. I mean, this is happening and I don't know what to do. And I don't know how to move forward. And brother, I don't know what to do. No worries. You, if you have the Holy Spirit, I mean, you will experience this thing, this incident in your personal life. You will experience this thing in your personal life. You don't know what to speak. You don't know what to do. But the Holy Spirit will tell you. You speak this word, and that will work out in that incident. Hallelujah. Praise God. In my spirit, I can understand. I can just discern that. And this is going to happen. This already happened in many of our lives, and this is going to happen in many of our lives in the coming days. Hallelujah. No, don't worry about all those things. I mean, what will I say? What will I do? No. God will give you. The Holy Spirit will teach you. The Holy Spirit will give you. This is the promise of God. This is the promise of God to the disciples. Amen. Hallelujah. Listen, you know, again, you know, when you study Bible, you will understand there are many people specifically illuminated by the Holy Spirit in Bible. Yeah, these are the examples that we can take. At the same time, let me encourage you that you can also be encouraged by this word, and you can also be illuminated by the Holy Spirit. Okay, the first person we can see about Simeon. Okay, S-I-M-E-O-N. Is it the pronunciation Simeon? മലയാളത്തിൽ സിമിയോൻ, സിമിയോ എന്നാ പറയുന്നത്, സിമിയൻ. ഓക്കെ, ബട്ടർ സൈമൺ ഓർ സംബഡി. ഓക്കെ, സിമിയൻ, വാട്ട് ഈസ് ഹാപ്പനിങ് ദേർ? സിമിയൻ, ഹി വുഡ് നോട്ട്, ഐ മീൻ ഗോഡ് സെഡ് ടു ഹിം, ഹി വുഡ് നോട്ട് ഡൈ അൻടിൽ ഹി സോ ദ മെസ്സയ ഇൻ ലൂക്ക് ചാപ്റ്റർ 2 വേഴ്സ് 26. ഓക്കെ, യു വിൽ നോട്ട് ഡൈ അൻടിൽ യു സീ മെസ്സയ. യു നോ ദാറ്റ് ഹി വാസ് he was living until the coming of the Jesus Christ. That means until the birth of Jesus Christ. Okay, he could see the birth of Jesus Christ. You know, when you know, this is the particular thing, that particular illumination which is given for some people. You know, you can also receive that illumination. I can also receive that illumination from the Lord through the Holy Spirit. You know, this illumination, and to say, I mean, God said, Jesus said that you will not die until you saw the Messiah. And again, Agabus, okay, Agabus is the second person that I would like to share with you, that, you know, he got the illumination by Spirit. Okay, Acts chapter 11 verse 28 we read, he was illuminated by the Spirit and he prophesied that there would be a great famine all over the world, and that happened. Agabus got a prophecy, Agabus got an illumination or revelation that he was saying that there will be a, in Acts chapter 11 verse 28, there is no time to read all those portions, you know, he was prophesying that you will have a great famine all over the world, and that happened. You know, again, when you think about Apostle Paul, many times had many illuminations in his life. He got many revelations in different places with different matters. You know, Paul received many visions from the Lord. Paul received many illumination from the Lord. I mean, the Holy Spirit was guiding that Apostle Paul in different places. The Holy Spirit was directing Apostle Paul in different places, and he was doing his ministry. So this is possible. You know, I was trying to tell you that the illumination of the Holy Spirit and the teaching of the Holy Spirit is possible even today. I don't know how many of you are receiving that illumination from the Lord, from the Holy Spirit. I mean, if you have experienced that, you will know that. Otherwise, you are going to experience that in the coming days. I mean, this is possible even today also. You will get, you know, നമ്മൾ മലയാളത്തിൽ പറയത്തില്ലേ, ഒരു പ്രത്യേക നിയോഗം കിട്ടി അല്ലേ, ഒരു പ്രത്യേക ഒരു നിയോഗം കിട്ടി. When I'm preparing the messages, you know, I used to pray in the presence of God like this: Lord, I need an illumination. No, without that, I will not preach. No, I will wait for the Lord. I'll sit in the presence of God. I sit in the presence of God maybe hours and hours and hours, and I prepare the message. When I'm preparing the message, I know that this is the message for the church. This is needed for the church, because I have the illumination in my heart that this could speak to the people, those who are coming on that Sunday. Hallelujah. That's the reason, you know, I'm sitting in the presence of God and asking, Lord, oh Lord, speak to me, oh Lord. I don't know what to speak. You know, I don't used to take all the old messages and preach in this church, you know. I never do that. You know, I have almost 20, 25 years experience, but I have many messages, the old ones. But I don't take all those things, because I'm preparing new messages for this church. Why? എന്തുകൊണ്ടാണ് അങ്ങനെ? എനിക്ക് അത് പണ്ടത്തെ പ്രസംഗം എടുത്തങ്ങ് പ്രസംഗിച്ചാൽ പോരെ മതി, പക്ഷെ അത് ചെയ്യത്തില്ല. കാരണം എന്താണെന്നറിയാമോ? ഐ നോ ദാറ്റ് ഗോഡ് ഹാസ് സംതിങ് സ്പെഷ്യൽ ടു സ്പീക്ക് ടു ദ പീപ്പിൾ ദോസ് വർ കമ്മിങ് ഓൺ എവറി സൺഡേ. Every Sunday, this morning, the Holy Spirit is speaking to you. I know that. The Holy Spirit is speaking to you that you have to experience the presence of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You know, there are many people illuminated by the Holy Spirit, and they are preaching, and they are doing something for the glory of the Lord. I mean, in the previous days, and again, we are going to see that. Hallelujah. Let me conclude with one more point, and we will pray. Hallelujah. And the third ministry is the ministry of making conviction in the heart of a person. Okay? പാപത്തെക്കുറിച്ചും നീതിയെക്കുറിച്ചും ന്യായവിധിയെക്കുറിച്ചുമുള്ള ബോധം വരുത്തുക എന്നുള്ളതാണ് പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാവിൻ്റെ ഒരു പ്രവൃത്തി, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ മിനിസ്ട്രി എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞത്. റീഡ് ദാറ്റ് വേഴ്സ്, ജോൺ ചാപ്റ്റർ 16 വേഴ്സ് 8. ജോൺ ചാപ്റ്റർ 16 വേഴ്സ് 8. ആൻഡ് ഐ വിൽ ബി പ്രീച്ചിങ് ദ സെയിം ടോപ്പിക് നെക്സ്റ്റ് വീക്ക് ഓൾസോ. ഓക്കെ, സോ okay, so three things are there. You know, three things are there. What is that? The sin and the righteousness and the judgment. Okay, when the Holy Spirit came upon this world, and when the Holy Spirit was, talking to the people, three things are happening. Sin is there, righteousness is there, and judgment is there. Okay, when a person is doing sin, you know, the righteousness is saying that, okay, no, don't do that. The Spirit of the Lord will say, don't do that, that's a mistake, that's a fault that you are doing. Don't repeat that, that's a sin. Then again, there are many people simply repeating all those sins, even knowing that this is a sin. Okay? Knowing that this is the mistake, they're repeating the same thing again and again. And the righteousness is there. No. If you're not doing that, the righteousness is there. You can be righteous by the blood of Jesus Christ. The righteousness is there. But if you are doing and repeating the same sin again and again, the next part is the judgment is there. So this thing is happening, this work is happening with the Holy Spirit. That means the Holy Spirit can convict the people about the sin, about the righteousness, and about the judgment. Hallelujah. And I thank the Lord that, there are many people understanding the voice of the Holy Spirit. There are many people, realizing the presence of the Holy Spirit in their life, and they are turning away from the sinful nature, and they are turning away from all the worldly pleasures, and asking for the righteousness of God, and they are not under the judgment of God. Hallelujah. But we know that there are many people still around us, still continuing in sin, and they do not know about the righteousness, and they are not ready to think about the righteousness, but they are waiting for a judgment of God. Hallelujah. Let's thank God that this morning, we are regenerated by the Holy Spirit. We believe that we are regenerated by the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We have the assurance that we are born again Christian. I am a born again Christian. How many can say that? Lift your hands and say, I'm a born again Christian. Hallelujah. I'm a born again Christian by the Spirit of the Lord. By the Spirit of the Lord. Hallelujah. The next ministry of the Holy Spirit is, hallelujah, teaching ministry and illumination ministry. That means the Spirit of the Lord will teach you many things. The Spirit of the Lord will give you something in your mouth to speak when you are going through the difficult situation. There are sometimes we are going through the difficult situation and we do not know what to say, we do not know what to do, but the Holy Spirit will teach you, the Holy Spirit will illuminate you what to speak and what to do. And last, the Holy Spirit will convict you about the sin, about the righteousness, and about the judgment. Let us all commit ourselves with the mighty hand of God. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Remember those verses and remember those points in your mind, and rededicate your life in the presence of God. I know that you are filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. I know that you are experiencing the presence of the Holy Spirit. But this morning, the Spirit of the Lord is saying, you rededicate your life in the presence of God. Rededicate your life in the presence of God for the work of the Holy Spirit in your life, for the ministry of the Holy Spirit in your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When you are filled with the Holy Spirit, many miracles will happen in and through your life. Hallelujah. When you're filled with the Holy Spirit, God will work many things through your life. Hallelujah. This morning, let us submit us with the mighty hand of God for the presence of the Holy Spirit. And let us experience the presence of the Holy Spirit in our life, in our church, hallelujah, in our meetings, in our fellowships, and in our church, Sunday service, hallelujah. When we are surrendered, under the presence of the Holy Spirit, there are things happening which is called miracles of the people, hallelujah. Thank you, Master. The healing will happen. Hallelujah. The deliverance will happen. The relatives will be coming to Christ. Your relatives will come to the Christ in the upcoming days. Only through the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. I know that there are many people praying for your parents, praying for your relatives, praying for your brothers and sisters. Oh, you're asking, oh Lord, they are not in Christ, oh Lord. Hallelujah. I believe that this morning through this word. I mean, I believe that the presence of the Holy Spirit will go to that place now, and those people will know about Jesus and the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. They will come back to Christ in the coming days. At home, you are praying for your husband, you are praying for your parents, praying for your relatives, praying for your brothers and sisters. I personally believe this morning the miracles are going to happen in your family. The miracles are going to happen in your family. The regeneration is going to happen in your family. The impossible things are going to be possible in 2022. Hallelujah. 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 You know that? Amen. Hallelujah. This is the last month of this year. But soon, soon, the 2022 is coming. Amen. There are things going to change, and there are miracles going to happen. The things which is impossible is going to become possible in 2022 in the coming days. Hallelujah. യേശുവിനധികാരമുള്ള നാമത്തിൽ അങ്ങനെ സംഭവിക്കട്ടെ. പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാവിന്റെ പ്രവൃത്തി ചില കുടുംബങ്ങളിൽ വെളിപ്പെടട്ടെ. Hallelujah. അസാധ്യമെന്ന് തോന്നിയ പല കാര്യങ്ങളും സാധ്യമാകുന്ന ദിവസങ്ങളായി അടുത്ത വർഷം മാറട്ടെ എന്ന് ഞാൻ തൽക്കാലം പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. In the mighty name of Jesus, things take place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Jesus, hallelujah. If you believe in that word, if you believe in that word, that is the promise of God. That is the word of God. That is not the word of a pastor. That is not the word of an elder. That is not the word of any person of this church. That is the word of God. It says that something is going to happen in the next year, that God will do miracles and many things in our families. Hallelujah. Let us pray together.